Hello and welcome to One North Maine. I'm your host, Jay Miller, and today's episode features the great Council on Aging program at the Mary Cruz Kennedy Senior Center.
Every time I come through the door, there's a beautiful feeling of peace and welcoming. There has never been any kind of negative feeling here at all. Everyone is upbeat. And that is something that you don't find too often.
For more than 50 years, the Council on Aging and versions of it have been an important part of Brockton. When seniors walk through the door, they're encouraged to be themselves, creating an engaging and dynamic environment.
Today's one of the best days of my life, and I'm going to enjoy this occasion. A new experience. Yeah!
The staff is second to none, and all play a pivotal role in enriching the lives of hundreds, even thousands of people annually. The straw that stirs the drink, Executive Director Janice Fitzgerald.
It also takes a village to make the Council on Aging so successful. I'd be a fool if I thought I was responsible for all that. I'm not. I need to say a big thank you to my staff. I've got Michelle Brace.
Another victory for Michelle Brace. I'm the Program Activities Coordinator here at the Brockton Council on Aging.
I have Dottie Slack.
I'm Dottie Slack. I'm the Health Education Outreach Coordinator at the Brockton Council on Aging.
We now have Frank, who we call Franklin when he misbehaves. And we also have our new employee, Carla, who's out front still working, checking in some people.
Hi, my name is Carla DeRosa, and I'm the Activity Assistant here at the Council on Aging.
We have a lot of fun. We have recreational, social activities here. We also have health information education programs, a little bit of everything here at the Council on Aging.
I help people with their insurance issues, with their mass health issues, with drug issues, or prescription issues. I also do many applications for Prescription Advantage, for housing, for self-help, for DTA, for fuel assistance. We serve 16,000 seniors in the city of Brockton, and at least 6,000 of them have come here to our center at one given time throughout the year.
You are watching BCA, Brockton Community Access, excellence in public, education, and government programming. We at BCA like to call the Council on Aging the COA. Alphabet soup, you may say. We say magic.
Nice and loud.
Those are the only words?
Thank you.
Oh, yeah.
If it's fun you're looking for, look no further than 10 Father Kenny Way. Good fun, Good times, good people.
All right, I am here at the Council on Aging. The volunteers around me are working feverishly to get ready for the Chinese New Year luncheon. Do you know what the New Year brings? What animal the New Year brings?
This is the year of the rat.
Is it the year of the rat or the year of the rooster?
Rooster, rooster.
All right, let me hear your best rooster.
He's the rat.
We have over 80 volunteers here at the Brockton Council on Aging. They're all seniors from Brockton and surrounding towns, and they're integral to us running our Council on Aging because we're a staff of 4.5. So without our volunteers, we couldn't do things like we have today, a party. We couldn't send out our newsletters. Nothing would be possible without them.
Council on Aging!
A lot of the things that happen here are happening because volunteers make it. So God love the volunteers who come here and do the work they do. It makes a huge difference, it really does.
The Council on Aging to me is a place where I can go, other seniors can go to take advantage of benefits, to take advantage of socializing with different people, and just having a place to hang out, basically. I love volunteering here. I do it at least once a week. And I get a good feeling from that.
Where were you born?
1914. I started World War I.
Where were you born? Were you born in Massachusetts?
Oh, yeah. I was born in Boston.
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 Born in Boston. What part of Boston?
Who knows?
Who knows?
Question, the Council on Aging's senior picnic is the most electric event in our city. Billy Kudo and the After Hours know how to get the crowd going. Feel free to get up and dance. Plenty of fun activities and events at the Mary Cruz Kennedy Senior Center. One thing that they do is they get engaged in their community and let their voices be heard. Few organizations recognize veterans quite like the COA. They pay tribute to those that have fallen, those that are no longer with us, and those that continue to lead fulfilling lives.
Thank you.
We want to thank everybody for coming out tonight to remember Jennifer on the anniversary of the night that she disappeared. We appreciate that everyone makes the effort and takes the time to join us to remember Jennifer. We ask that you, along with Jennifer's mother and her family and the other investigators, if you'll join us in a quick prayer for Jen and our family and for strength and for answers. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
To this day, I do believe that the people that lived here at the time Jennifer went missing do know where she is. And hopefully we're going to find that out and bring Jen home.
It is so needed because there are so many elderly people that have no place to go and nothing to do. And they come here and there is everything for them. Anything you could ask for, from cards and games of pool and the yoga that we do and the aerobics that my friends do, it's just wonderful. And there's so much help here. Anything that you need for help, it's there.
I sometimes talk about my dad, particularly when I'm here speaking at the Council on Aging. You know, we started the Senior Safety Task Force last year, and as we identified some of the issues that we wanted to look at and make a difference on, there were certainly issues that I think about every day with my dad, who, you know, still lives on his own. And so, you know, we worry about them, you know, being targets of scams or fraud. We worry about their safety.
One of the most important days on the calendar is World Elder Abuse Awareness Day. The COA teams up with Old Colony Elder Services and they march down Main Street to not only raise awareness, but hopefully reach those that need some help.
Each and every year, myself and my team in Perry and OCES know that if this rock made a difference in one person's life, then we've done a great thing. Today, we have balloons, and balloons to me symbolize freedom. So at the count of three, I want you all to let your balloons go for those people who are suffering in silence, but hopefully today they saw us and they know that there's support and help out there for them. So on the count of three, we're gonna let it go. One, two, three.
We have a drug take-back program as part of our, it's the city's opioid treatment. And the city has people come here to the Council on Aging about four times a year, and you can just drop off medications that you might have in your medicine cabinet. Many, many seniors save medications, and that becomes a problem because sometimes the medications can be taken by a family member, or the senior might accidentally overdose on some medications. Many seniors, when they go to the hospital, they come home on different drugs, and they don't recognize that they shouldn't be taking the medications that they were taking prior to their hospitalization.
We are hosting the Prescription Drug Take Back with the Council on Aging, and this has been a really successful program in getting unused, potentially very dangerous and addictive drugs off the streets of our city before they fall into the wrong hands and get misused by someone. Also keeps our seniors much safer, and you're not a target to be robbed if someone were to know that you were in possession of some prescription medication they might like to get their hands on. So it keeps you guys safer, it makes the city safer. And Janice, thank you for the Council on Aging being such a great partner. Thank you.
Dottie Slack often partners up with Julie Lom of the Brockton VNA. Make sure not to miss one of their Brockton Knocks Down Diabetes meetings.
No, I beg you for your forgiveness!
Our our One North Main crew simply loves the staff at the COA. And they love to have fun, just like us. I can't wait to get inside, but, oh, hey, look. It's Janice Fitzgerald and Dottie Slack. I'm gonna go see what they're up to.
Hey, hi, Jay.
Hi, Jay.
Ah, two of my favorite people, Janice, Dottie. It's always a pleasure seeing both of you. I am fired up. Today, I am wearing my Western boots because of the country Western theme that you have going on at the cookout today.
You don't have any shoelaces. What's going on?
Do you need some money? We can get you some shoes.
See, ladies, the beautiful thing about not wearing shoelaces is I can flip my boots off and frolic free in the grass. Whew, sure is a hot one out here today, ladies. I don't know, I probably should go to my car and grab a hat. So?
Jay, what's with the hat? It's 90 degrees.
You look like Elmer Fudd.
Look like a little Irish guy from South Boston with a Scully cap on. You're keeping those ears safe from the sun, are you?
On a safari, safari, yes, we're going away.
Say, what's the big idea?
You really look like a movie star.
Mafia.
The glasses make the hat, but boy, does the hat make the man.
Man, the COA, again, the place to be. Halloween party, loving life, but I'm starving. Oh, look, there's some popcorn. Ooh, ow!
I love working with people. I love giving back to the community. And it's just a lot of fun. And it's all about giving and sharing and all of that. I'm also a senior here at the center as well, and I like the activities here, and Janice, the staff, they are perfect, they are great, they are so personable with everyone, and we do a lot of things here.
Why is everybody wearing green?
I don't know.
It's St. Patrick's Day.
Happy St. Patrick's Day.
That when we do this event as of lately, I can't be any more aware of someone who's missing, which would be Senator Tom Kennedy. So every year he would be here with a little Irish poem. He'd bring us our little shamrock plants, and he'd be wearing his green. So today we certainly want to remember Senator.
I'm wearing my green for St. Patrick's Day. And my headrest, you like it? It's pretty, isn't it? It's different.
It sure is.
I even have fingernails that are green.
Honestly, I can honestly say that it's great to have all the elected officials here, and I'm really happy to see most of them. So.
Mrs. Cohen, are you ready for your close-up?
Yes, I'm ready for my close-up.
I came in on Monday after it was we were notified that we could sign up for the St. Patrick's Day party. By Monday noontime, this room was full, and we had at least 30 people on the wait list. And the reason that that happened is because we're only allowed to have 150 people in this room. What we have right now are plans to add on an addition out back. And we need a lot of money to put that addition on. This building cost $8 million, and that was in 2000. We need at least $500,000 to $1 million to add on to this building.
We started our fundraising to add on to the center. Remember that? We named that light switch, which, Councilor, what does it say on that light switch over there, Councilor Studensky? What does it say? All right, so last year we raised funds and we named that light switch after you. We have two more switches if anyone feels so inclined to donate. Councilor Cruz has thrown out the challenge. He has just donated, drum roll please, $250 towards, and he wrote in the memo line, for the light switch.
One quick St. Patty's Day story, then we get on to dinner. So, for those of you that are Irish, know that we actually celebrate St. Patrick's Day week. This is not limited to a one-day celebration. So I did stop by at an Irish pub the other day as part of the week celebration, and great atmosphere, and this one Irish gentleman at the bar proposes a toast to, he says, here's to County Cork. Buys everybody a drink, and the guy sitting next to him says, whoa, you're from County Cork? So am I. And he buys everybody a drink, a round for everybody. So then the first guy goes again, and he now says, well, here's to everyone from Dublin. And the other guy says, oh, I'm from Dublin too. Let's buy a drink for everybody. So now the first guy says, well, here's to everyone from Clancy Street in Dublin. And the other guy says, you're from Clancy Street? So am I. Buy a drink for everybody. And so finally, you know, my curiosity was killing me, and I said something to the bartender, and I said, gee, does that sort of thing go on here all the time? He says, oh, no, 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 that's just the Donovan brothers getting drunk again.
Hi there.
If I get another shot of you, maybe I'll have 100.
You know what? Funny you should say that, because I've been keeping track. You've taken 99. This will be 100.
Really? All right. I'm taking you. There we go. We hit 100.
Yay. Can I have a round of applause, please?
Yay. Yay.
Outstanding.
Thank you. Really?
In school. All right.
sure that I come here because I get all the support, all the love, all the warmth that anyone could possibly need in their lifetime, and it's all right here.
They don't act like they're so much younger than us. You know, you talk to some young folks and they don't want to be bothered with seniors. You have a group of staff that they do want to be bothered with seniors, and they come up to our level, I'll put it that way, because we're not going down to theirs.
They keep you going here, you know? It makes you feel alive.
You are welcomed, you are feel you're a part of something, and you're included, and people are happy, and we all work towards encouraging each other every day.
Council on Aging is a wonderful resource here in the City of Champions. I don't think anybody does it better.
I don't either. I mean, they have a small staff, not a tremendously large budget, but if you look at the quality of the programs and services that they offer, it's quite extraordinary. And it's really needed because, as you and I know, the senior population is increasing at a pretty good percentage.
There's no better place to learn than at the feet of a senior that you're just getting to know. They've lived a lifetime of experiences that I'll never live. So it's really a rewarding job being here.
Some kind of wonderful, some kind of wonderful, yeah, she's right. Some kind of wonderful, yeah, 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 yeah. One more time. Now Israel and Bobby got
a sweet... Man, I feel refreshed. Being at the Council on Aging makes me feel young inside. What a great program, great staff, and fabulous volunteers. We wish them the best of luck moving forward in our fair city. To learn more about Brockton Community Access, please visit our website at bcatv.org. You can also check out our YouTube channel, youtube.com/thebrocktonchannels, all one word. For executive producer Mark Lindy and producer Aaron Tebow, I'm Jay Miller, and we will see you around town.
Across the USA.
Why is everybody wearing green today? I don't get it.
Jay, it's stuck on your belt.
Don't look down, but it is stuck on my belt. Did you know January 1st in the Chinese culture is called First Dawn? However, the Chinese New Year is known as the Spring Festival. If you see Janice Fitzgerald walking down the street, tell her to stop heckling me, please. What are you ladies doing today?
I'm crocheting, and I'm showing her how to crochet.
Okay. I think I need to take up crocheting because I was in the origami room, and look what happened to my head. Those are all paper cuts.
Oh my God.
This paper used to be white.
Are you serious?
I'm never serious.
How are you?